Welcome to the Cafe Ex Machina YouTube channel. I have been a supporter of Prusa for years. The quality of Prusa has been in a league of its own. The idea has been this: if you want to have 3D printers as a hobby, buy a Creality. But if you simply want a 3D print, there is no other option than Prusa. I personally own a Creality Ender 6 printer, and it is perhaps the worst 3D printer in the history of the world. At work, we use Prusa MK3S and MK4S printers, which have practically never let us down. This reliability of Prusa is exactly what I expect from the Bambu H2D printer. Send the G-code to the printer, click print, and wait until the print is finished. I ordered this new release a month ago, and by the way, it is big, an enormous chunk of a machine. Bambu has done a good job overall. The printer is well packaged and made from high quality materials. Carefully packed, the printer arrives intact even from the other side of the world. When unpacking the package, it is advisable to have a friend to help. Moving and unboxing such a large printer is quite challenging. At this stage, the shape of the printer starts to reveal itself, and it becomes strikingly clear how high quality the materials are and how well designed the overall construction is, especially when compared to the products from Prusa or Creality. Once the plastics and cardboards have been removed from around the printer, it is time to move on to unpacking its internal components. The printer's AMS2 Pro unit is screwed to the inside of the printer, so there are about a dozen screws to remove. This structure helps to make the printer frame more rigid during transportation. Everything shows that Bambu has invested time and effort into the design and industrial styling of the device. I never thought I would say that a 3D printer looks good, but this one truly does. At this point, the printheads are secured with zip ties, which feels like a somewhat cheap solution in an otherwise well-designed system. Next comes the unboxing and assembly of the AMS2 Pro unit. On that note, it's worth mentioning that Prusa's MMU unit is more or less a joke, a poor purchase that isn't worth a single euro. Structurally, the AMS2 Pro unit is quite impressive. How well it performs over time remains to be seen. At least the installation of the AMS unit is easy. The PTFE tube is connected from the unit to the printer's attachment point, and the 6-pin power and data cable is plugged into the printer. That's it. The H2D printer has two printheads. I connect the AMS unit to the right-hand printhead and the external filament holders to the left-hand printhead. Finally, the security plug and power cable are installed, and the printer is powered on. In theory, the printer is now ready for use. Before printing, it is recommended to calibrate the printer. The calibration process takes about 30 minutes. Here it is in fast forward. Finally, I'm printing a magnetic holder tool. The Prusa MK3S completed this with the same quality in 2 hours and 8 minutes. The Bambu H2D does it in just 30 minutes, an absolutely magical performance. Bambu has done its homework thoroughly and built the best workhorse on the market. Joseph, when can we expect something similar from you? Thank you for watching.